We're talking about winterizing your house, right? You winterize your house, you winterize your cars, but what about your pets?
There are so many do's and even more don'ts when it comes to your pets being outside during these harsh winter months.
Yeah, so I sat down with Dr. Andrew Dennis of the Bloomfield Animal Hospital to talk about all the things winter when it comes to your pets, from booties to coats. We've got you covered.
Take a look.
The Zidane sisters, Nikki and Ellie, are being dropped off for a checkup here at the Bloomfield Animal Hospital. And while they're here, one of them is going to be our model when it comes to talking about all things winter, because there's a lot to know about pet care during the cold winter months.
Hi, everybody. I'm here with Dr. Andrea Dennis from the Bloomfield Animal Hospital in Bloomfield, Connecticut. Nice to see you.
It's nice to see you too, Scott.
We are talking about cold weather and pets.
Yes.
And how to keep them safe and protocols and things like that today.
Exactly.
So what do we have here?
This is Miss Nikki.
The first thing you're going to notice about Miss Nikki is her short hair. Not ideal for hanging outside.
A lot of it has to do with their breed, has to do with that hair coat as well. And you see how they get groomed on a regular basis, and her hair coat is a little bit on the short side. There's really no undercoat. Like, you can see her skin.
Yeah.
It's not like the Siberian Husky that has that thick undercoat.
Right.
If it starts getting below 30 degrees, you want to sort of limit how much time you spend outside with them.
So the lighter the coat, the more concerned you are about
frostbite and hypothermia, exactly.
Okay.
The other thing is age. How old are they?
Yeah.
So if the elderly and the puppies and kittens, those are the ones you don't really want them out at all. Just minimize it so they can go to the bathroom, a little bit of a walk around the yard, and then come back inside when it's very cold. And I think we really start to think when it's less than 32 degrees. Anything less than 20, I would absolutely not take them out whatsoever.
Less to go to the bathroom?
Just to go to the bathroom.
Another thing to consider about pets in the cold outdoors?
Are they sick? That's the other thing to keep in mind. Do they have hypothyroidism? Do they have kidney failure? Keeping them warm is critical. And it's not just about outdoors, even indoors. You know, there are people come sometimes keep their house a little on the drafty side. So cats, you have to be concerned about them too.
To keep your pet warm inside, Dr. Dennis says give them some towels fresh out of the dryer to lay on, but don't use heating pads.
I'm not for using those, because especially when a cat or even a small dog is sick, they're in this warm environment and it's too warm, it can burn them.
Okay.
So try to avoid electric blankets and electric heating pads. No matter what. It's just not, because then you walk away, and if they're too weak to really get up or realize that they're getting too hot, I've seen burns. We've seen them here.
Ooh, terrible.
Taking your dog for a walk, here are some tips to keep them comfy when venturing outside.
This is a coat for a dog. I say that, you know, this is ridiculous, but you say they actually come in handy.
Oh my goodness,
and they're
yes.
good for them.
They are, and I wasn't a coat person either, but then everybody that does come here has a coat for their dog, and they have different outfits too. But this coat in particular is perfect for the winter because it's nice and soft, and it's easy to put on.
And it really does help them stay warm.
It does. Just like humans.
We wear boots. How about our pups?
How many times do we talk about their paws, all right, and making sure that snow doesn't get caught in the bottom of the pads,
right.
To make sure that ice melt is also a major concern. So there are things that we can do. You've heard about those little booties that we can put on. Let's just have this as a warning. Not every dog is going to want to put a bootie on.
No.
So sometimes,
I think the majority don't like them.
You're right.
Yeah.
You're right.
Dr. Dennis suggests trying a sock on your dog first to see if they'll tolerate that. If they do, the boots might be a go.
Now, you want to make sure when you do these little booties that they are not too big. And I would say this one's probably a little bit too big for my
girl. Yeah, it looks like it's half the size of the dog.
It does. Yeah, and it's like putting on a shoe, and her toe's right here. Her big toe is right there.
Right.
But again, what she's doing is that she's allowing us to put it on, and she's putting that foot down.
Okay.
And that's an excellent sign, that the fact that she's just leaving it down, she's not lifting it up, she's not shaking her paws, that's a real good sign.
Miss Nikki, how do you feel about that?
Because I want the matching one. You're such a good girl.
So again, it's toleration. Will they tolerate it?
Right, because they work really well. And again, it avoids the salt, it avoids the snow, it avoids the wetness.
If it's a no-go with the booties, Dr. Dennis recommends a product called Mushers. It's an ointment that goes on the pads of their paws, a way to protect them.
Another suggestion for the winter is just making sure they've had their annual exam. you haven't been to a veterinarian in 2 years, 3 years, just have them checked out.
All right, that way you're going to know your dog or cat is in tip-top shape and what they might need to handle the great outdoors.
I can't imagine putting booties on a cat.
Mark Zinni's dog.
Mark Zinni puts the booties on the dog, right? Guess it just depends.
All right.
Dr. Dennis also recommends always wiping down your pet's paws after they come inside. Dr. Dennis is at the Bloomfield Animal Hospital. You can visit her on online. Check it out at bloomfieldanimalhospitalct.com.
She's also on News Talk 1080 every other Saturday talking about pets as well. Thanks, Doc. Appreciate it.